What's up, guys? Welcome back to the TenorShare channel. When you try to open a web page with Safari, it might give you an error that says Safari cannot open the page because your iPhone is not connected to the internet, but in fact it is, or because the address is invalid, or because the server stopped responding, or because it could not establish a secure connection to the server. No matter what it is, I'll help you fix it in this video. Let's dive in. The first thing to do is to test your network connection. You can turn airplane mode on and off. After your network is resumed, try to load a different website, like apple.com, or try if you can load data on apps like YouTube or Unsplash. If not, switch to cellular data or connect to a different Wi-Fi network for a change. If you have a VPN turned on, some apps or websites might block content from loading, so make sure to turn it off. A wrong data and time also derail the network, so our next time is go to general, data and time. Make sure it's set automatically. If only Safari lost access to the internet, go to apps using WLAN and cellular, and make sure you have granted Safari to use data. If your network's still not working, go to general, transfer or reset iPhone. Then go ahead and reset network settings to default. Just make sure you have your Wi-Fi password ready. Safari generates caches and data every time you visit the websites, so our next step is check Safari settings. In your settings app, scroll down and tap Safari. Scroll to the bottom and tap Advanced. Tap Website Data. You'll be able to see all your cookies. Scroll down and go ahead to remove all website data. If you've installed any Safari extensions, make sure that they're up to date, or just turn it off at the moment. To make all the changes take full effect, let's give the phone a fresh restart. For iPhone 8 or later, press and quickly release the volume up button. Press and quickly release the volume down button. Then press and hold the side button. Let it go when you see the Apple logo. Sometimes the issue is related to some system glitches. Then the best option for you is to repair the iOS with Reboot. The standard repair feature helps recover the system while keeping all your data preserved. After downloading the firmware, you can start the repair. This process takes about 10 minutes. Once completed, check if your Safari is acting normal again. So that's it. Thanks for watching. For more tips like this, subscribe to the TenorShare channel or click another video to keep watching now. See you next time.